Hello everybody, welcome to episode 2 on learning how to draw from A to Z fundamentals. In today's video, I will show you how you can take your sketch to the next level using straight and curved lines and how to identify characteristics of specific animals. So without wasting any time, let's start working. Okay, welcome back to my computer. So without wasting any time, let's jump into it. So today we're gonna learn how to draw birds. Firstly, we're gonna use fundamental basic shapes in order to get an idea of the lines that we're gonna draw. And then secondly, we're gonna use straight line and curved lines in order to make our sketch look more realistic. So let's bring in some birds. As you can see, I have a huge collection. And we're gonna start with this one, okay? So first things first, let's identify the shapes, shall we? Then let's zoom in, okay? Let's start with the peak. So what do we see here? We do have a lovely triangle, and then we're gonna have a lovely circle. For the body, we can also represent it with a circle. And then for the legs here, we're gonna have some triangle. The legs, as you see, they lean forward. Perfect. For the tail, we do have triangle shape. Okay, so we're gonna represent it with two triangle shapes. For the eyes, let's draw them with a nice circle. Okay, and now with this one finished, let's examine it a little bit more. And I'll show you the importance of having basic sketches. So firstly, let's call this basic shapes. Okay, and we're gonna take this one and we're gonna make a duplicate for it. And let's place this one somewhere on the top. Why? Because we want to track the entire progress. Okay, so let's place this one somewhere around here. We won't play with it for now. Okay, now let's go back to this basic shape and let's come closer. Here we want to examine some things on it, and for that I will use another color, red. Well, what can you see in this design? We do have some cutouts. So we do have a cutout on the tail, a cutout on the head, especially on the neck area, and a cutout for the pig. And those cutouts, they will be our anchor points. Now, let's bring our design back. Let's take this shape and let's place it on the top next to the other one. Okay, perfect. Now we have two basic ideas. Now we do know the anchor points. Let's see what else can we do. So let's go to this design, let's create a new layer. Let's draw the anchor points. Why? Because we already know where they are. So let's represent the anchor points, shall we? As you can see, this bird is kind of like an angle. So because of that, we're gonna cut it somewhere around here. Okay, now let's cut the neck and cut the tail. Perfect. Now we want to sketch using straight lines and curved lines for this. Now how to do that? First, let's represent the eye with a circle. Next, we want to connect this point, and let me change the color, it will be easier to follow. And let's connect it with a straight line. Here on the top, we want to give a nice curvature because why? The head is a circle, at least the way we represent it on the top, isn't it? Now, let's create the beak. The beak is a nice triangle. Now, let's look at the body area. So what we want to do, we want to go to the top and we're gonna go and draw a straight line to connect with the lower anchor. Okay, and from here, we're gonna draw a curved line all the way to the lower anchor. Perfect. Now, let's draw the triangle. And let's create another triangle for the tail. And let's see for the wing. So we can see the wing is here. We can create a lovely arc. We're gonna cut it like this and we're gonna close it. Okay, so let's see what we have so far. Let's draw the legs very fast. Triangle, triangle, tuck. And now let's have a look on what we have created. As you can see right now, it looks much more realistic compared to how it was before. Now let me very fast clean this artwork. Okay, and let's bring this one on the top next to the others. Now let's compare them together. Now, as you can see, we started with the basic shape. From the basic shape, we took the anchor points. Once we identify the anchor points, we start drawing our design based on the shapes. You can see here we have the roundness, So we apply the roundness on the top, and this lower part, we just connect them together with straight lines. And now we have a better representation of this design. But I'm still not happy with how it looks like. I want a little bit more than this. So let's sketch another one. We're gonna apply the same principle. Again, we're gonna go to the top, we're gonna cut it, let's connect them together. Okay, really nice and smooth. And let's cut this one. Now here, let's draw the peak. Now, as you can see here, the peak is separated in two. So let's draw this line first and let's close the peak. Okay. Now let's see from where the middle of the eye go. So if I go from the peak and here I will draw a straight line, as you can see, the eye is a little bit above this line. So this means from the peak, I will go a little bit offset on the top in order to create our eye. Now, each bird have different characteristics, so by drawing your guides, it will help you a lot later on. Now, here, let's draw the rest of the anchors. So we do have the tail, so we're gonna cut this, and let's see with the body. What characteristics do you see on this bird? If I draw like this, well, it's not very realistic. So now let's see some characteristics of this bird. If you look around the chest area, what can you see? As you can see, this area is bolded compared to the other one. This one can be represented by a straight line. Well, this one, it's curved. The curve is more pronounced. So because of that, we're gonna focus on the curve around this area, and then we're just gonna go and draw a straight line towards the bottom. So we're gonna have this representation. Now, let's go on the top. Here, we can actually draw a straight line all the way down. Now the question is, how about the tail? We don't want to just go and just add triangle. We need to examine the shape of the bird a little bit more. So here we do want to follow the line of the body. The same on the bottom. We're going to follow the curvature of the body. So because of that, here what we want to do, from this point, we're just going to go down, and here we're going to close the triangle. Again, we're going to try to follow the curvature. As you can see, it will go and it will close here. Now, for the rest of the tail, as you can see here, this one usually follows again this line of the body. Okay, so we're gonna go from here, something like this, and we're gonna close it. And here, if you want, we can give a nice curvature to it. Now, let's go for the legs. Again, we're gonna follow with a triangle. And here, as you can see, the legs for the bird usually tend to lean forward, and let's represent. Now, as you can see, this bird has three toes in the front and one at the back. Well, we almost finished with this one. Why I'm saying that? Well, we do have the wing, isn't it? So in our case, as you see, the bird is kind of an angle. So the wing kind of starts from here and goes like this. Okay, so in our case, the wings initially was a lovely triangle. Okay, but we do want to give some shape to it. So here, we can represent this with a nice curvature all the way down. We're gonna cut it and going all the way down with a curvature that leaves in a little bit. It's kind of like a straight line, but curved in a little bit. But let's, for simple tutorial use, we're gonna represent it with a straight line. So now we have this. And let's compare this one with the others. Let's see how we progress. So again, basic shapes, anchor points, we start adding curvature and straight lines to our design, we start taking the bird characteristic into consideration, and now it looks better than before. But again, now with this in mind, let's try to see if we can reproduce the entire thing again, but without the picture. And voila, this is a really nice and cool way to sketch a bird. Now let's see, can we apply this principle to other birds? So let me scale this down first. And now let's practice with other birds. We're gonna examine their characteristics and things that they have in common and what is different. So for that, I will bring in another one. Let's see, we're gonna take this one for example. Let's bring it in. Okay, now let's see on this bird, can we apply the same principle as before? As you can see here, we do have these three areas that we focus on. So for the head, we have a straight line, curved. For the body, we're gonna have here a straight line, a curve towards the chest area with a straight line, and then triangle for the tail that will follow the line of the body. Now let's see, can the same principle be applied to this new bird? So let's try to find out, shall we? So let's go to the bird. Again, we're gonna draw our anchor points. But again, this bird is in a, the body is placed in such in a specific angle. So here, I could draw a straight line, but if I'm observing the line of the tail, this means the body has a curvature, as you can see on the wings as well. So we're gonna give a curvature. So we're gonna give a slight curvature to the body. The same here, we're gonna start with a bolded chest and then straight line towards the edge. We're gonna continue the lines in order to create the tail, and from inside, we're gonna draw the other triangle in order to fill in the tail. For the wings, we're gonna start with a nice line. We're gonna give a curvature and we go outside. Okay, so this is what we have so far. As you can see, for the head, is a little different right now. Before, the curve was more pronounced, like quite simple, quite close to a circle. This one, on the other hand, is like an horizontal ellipse. So because of that, for this one, we're gonna have a higher curvature to it. Okay, and here we're gonna draw a straight line. For the beak, same as before, we're gonna cut the beak in half, connect the lines to create triangle shape. And here, again, we're gonna draw the line that is above our guideline. So as you can see, the principle, let's represent the legs. As you can see, the principle is the same as the other. So we do have the fundamental shapes of our designs. Let's scale it down and let's compare them. Okay, so as you can see, we do have the fundamental shapes of the design. The kingfisher design and this design is almost the same lines. Just the characteristic of the wings. This one has a lower wing, this one has a smaller and yet more rounded wing. This head is more stretched compared to this one that is more round. But the principle of the shape of the head and the beak is drawn in the same way. Well, let's try another bird to find out, shall we? We are really curious to see if a lot of birds have things in common. So let's bring in another one. Let's zoom out and let's find another one. Let's take this one. Pretty interesting bird. Now let's see, will the same shapes apply in this situation? So we do have the beak, okay, we cut the neck, the tail. Again, as you can see, the characteristic of the chest is really rounded, and then from here it just go in lovely into a straight line. Same here, we're gonna go with a straight line. We're gonna continue the line. Actually, this line has kind of a curvature to it. And then we're gonna go down and we're gonna complete the tail. And then here we're gonna have the other shape. As you remember, I mentioned before, it can be a triangle if it's closed. If it's open, the shape will change. So we could represent it with a triangle that goes from inside out, something like this. And it looks really nice. The inside part, we can actually erase it. And let's see what we have. Really cool. Let's represent the wings. So again, we're gonna have a lovely curvature that goes out. We're gonna cut it and let's close the lines. For the legs, here, as you can see, we do have a triangle that goes here and inside. The same for the other side. And then the legs just pop out. Now for the neck, here we're gonna represent the beak. In our case, the beak is curved, and let's represent, and we're gonna go up and gonna cut the line. And then here we're just gonna go draw a line to close it. So we have this curvature on the top of it. Again, the eye is on the top of the offset line, and we're gonna close this with a nice curve and a line. So as you saw, the same principle applied to draw this falcon. And it looks pretty cool. Again, let's scale it down and let's try other birds, shall we? Let's bring in another one. So I will fast forward the process in order for you to see more drawings with this. So this is a really fast and cool way to create your own sketches. But if you do want to take your design a little bit further, all you have to do now is to learn about the bird's open wings. So what we want to do, let's take some birds that fly and let's examine them with open wings. What do they have in common, shall we? So for this one, I will use this design. We want to examine the birds in different angles. So same as before, we're gonna cut the neck area. We're gonna cut the tail area. As you can see, around the chest is bolded and then it goes slowly towards the body. Straight line, give a nice bold. We're gonna go with triangle to fill in the tail, and our initial shape that will have been something like this, now it's wide opened, so it will go somewhere like this. Now let's examine the wings a little bit. So for the wings, we do want to take the midpoint, okay, as an anchor point, and let's close it like this, and let's create a rectangular shape. Okay, so now for the wings, we're gonna represent them with a rectangular shape. And this one, we're going to push it up and we're going to close it with a lovely triangle. Now, for the head, we're going to cut the beak out. Okay. And represent the top of the bird with a round edge. Perfect. So now we have our lovely, let's close the rectangular shape. We have our lovely flying bird. Now let's bring down a little bit, let's place it sideways, and let's examine another flying bird, shall we? Let's bring in this one. Let's increase the size. And let's examine this one. Same as before. Big. In our case, this one is very... I won't be able to do it with this brush, but I'll just not cut it in the middle. Okay. We have the eye offset a little bit. We cut the neck, cut the tail. This characteristic, as you can see, is much more bolded around the belly area, this one. So we have the straight line that goes down and then becomes curved. Here we have the straight line all the way down, and then let's see where those lines intersect. And here on the top, as you can see, we do have our tail. In our case, we can represent it with another triangle. Again, here we have the legs, and let's see the wings. Does the same principle apply as before? So let's examine. Let's cut it and make a parallel line towards the to the body. Let's connect the lines, and here let's close it with a triangle. Here let's draw this with a nice curve, and voila, we have sketched another bird. Now I'm interested in one more angle, and after that we want to use the same principle to create one of our own unique design. So for this one, let's bring in this falcon. I really like the way this falcon is. And now we have finished, and let's close the back with a nice curve. So let's see what we have. Okay, now the biggest question is, can we create our own sketch based on what we have here so far? Well, let's give a try, shall we? So I will go here, I will choose the brush tool, and let's see. And voila, we have sketched this out and it looks pretty cool. Now let's see if I can draw really fast using these two as a time lapse. Let's see what can we create out of them, shall we? So I will speed up this part. okay guys, we finished sketching, and check it out, this is just an improvisation done on the spot. I have no idea what kind of bird it is, but I just wanted to draw it, and it looks pretty cool as a sketch. The same with this one, we took the falcon and we have tried to recreate it, tried to give more cleanness to it. Yeah, I do have to make a little work on the feathers, but as I said, this is just a sketch. When I will transform this into a vector, the effect will be different, especially when I will apply shadows and highlights and more details to it. But again, as I mentioned, as a sketch, it does a really pretty cool job. So don't forget the fundamentals that I always stress out. Start with your basic shape. This is really important. After you find your basic shape, identify the anchor point that will help you to draw your sketch. After that, apply straight lines and curves line to it. Do not care about the characteristic of an object, just make it look better. And after you get familiar with step 3, then you start analyzing the characteristics of each individual. So as you can see, this bird has more rounded chest, the back is quite flat, and the tail is it's actually longer. The beak is pretty small. On the other hand, this one has a longer beak, more stretched head, and more rounded body. Okay guys, that's it for today's video. I hope you found this approach useful and you learned something new. Please leave a comment down into the comment section. What do you think about this? And if you have any questions, I'll be happy to help you out with the entire process. And don't forget to join in our Facebook community. The link will be down into the description if you have any questions regarding this. And I will be happy to help you out throughout your journey. Click the like button if you enjoyed the video. It will help a lot with the algorithm. And subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already. So until tomorrow, have a nice day. Bye bye.